We're not kids anymore. I mean, what did you think? We're just gonna sit in my basement all day? Play games for the rest of our lives?
I know you can't really talk too much about season three or reveal too much, so I kind of wanted to talk about what we've seen so far. Mm-hmm. So the show opens with four friends playing Dungeons and Dragons. Being a kid of the 80s yourself, what video game or board game did you most enjoy playing with your friends?
I mean, I was a Dungeons and Dragons kid up until like, I think like fifth grade I was really into it, and we had like a little club and we played, like the six of us. And then, you know, I also loved video games. I mean, ever since when I was a kid, there were systems called the Odyssey system, ColecoVision, the Atari, you know, and then like Nintendo came around and Super Mario Brothers was like mind blowing. But I loved all the, and then arcade games too. Like I used to go to the arcade and play Galaga and like Wizard of War and these like games. There was a place, like a pancake breakfast place, where they had all these like video games that where I lived when I was growing up. And we used to go there every Saturday and I used to just like play. So I'm very good at video games,
which
yeah, not a skill you want to brag about so much sometimes, but it just means you spend a lot of time in a dark room perfecting something.
Yeah, well, I find it impressive because I'm horrible at video games.
Are you?
I play them all the time, but I'm just not very good. Yeah.
I'm horrible at the modern ones because they're really difficult, but these older ones I like.
Yeah, I like these a lot. But so out of Will, Lucas, Dustin, and Mike, who would you say you were most like as a kid?
I would say definitely Will. Like, I've even shared on my Instagram some photos of me next to him, and I have that exact same bowl cut.
Really?
Yeah, exact same bowl cut. And I looked a lot like him. And I was, you know, although I was sort of outgoing, I mean, I inside I was just a very sensitive kid and a bit nerdy, you know, and not quite as popular. So I think that I identify with his kind of sensitivity.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, obviously we know how much Eleven loves Eggo waffles. Is there a food or snack that you love as much as she loves Eggos?
Wow, that's a good question. I mean, unfortunately, I like all kinds of food. And I gotta say, like, being in the South, because my whole family's from Houston.
Oh, okay.
And so I grew up like eating barbecue, like the brisket, sliced brisket that you guys have down here, which is different than like, you know, different than like Oklahoma or like Atlanta barbecue. It's like its own thing.
Yeah.
And so coming down here for a couple of days, I did have some barbecue that was extraordinary. So yeah, if I could eat barbecue every day and not, you know, have a heart attack, I think I would love to do that.
Okay, yeah. So what I love about Stranger Things is that it kind of gives that nostalgia of great 80s movies, like Goonies, that I used to watch over and over again. And I feel like other films and TV shows have tried to kind of capture that essence, but haven't succeeded. What is it about this show that is actually able to pull off that kind of like 80s cinema magic?
It's a really great question. I wish I could answer it succinctly. Because one of the things I find so masterful about the show is that it is so watchable. Like, and in fact, even I remember last year getting, you know, like some reviews come in and they get, like, there was a review that was real snooty that was like, you know, it's not as good as season one, it's not as blah, 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 blah. But I watched it all like in a day. And I'm like, that in and of itself is very difficult. Like I find for shows, even when they're good or whatever, like it's just hard to sit down and watch them. Like you get a little bit like, cause my attention span or whatever. And this show, it just seems so watchable. In a way, like when Back to the Future comes on TV, I'll sit down and watch the whole rest of the thing. Like when I see it and I'm like in the middle, I'll watch the rest of it. And in that way, the show has the same quality. I mean, that's just the special genius of the Duffer Brothers in the sense that we're not recreating, we're not doing like a reboot of Back to the Future, but we're using the language or the alphabet of the emotional texture of those movies and applying it to a new story.
Yeah.
So you still get the newness of the story, but you have the, you know, the kind of beats and the emotional texture of those films, which were sort of more earnest, maybe.
Or
more, there was a kind of, like, I think the world grows more cynical kind of as we go along. And
it's true.
I think there was an earnestness to it that they unabashedly, like, go for with the show.
Yeah.
Which I really like.
And it's true. And it's that's crazy that you say that, because season two was the one that I watched in, like, 2 days. Because it was so good.
You just, like, it's like candy, right?
Yeah.
You just get,
it's
you can't
addicting.
Stop.
That's why I can't wait for season 3.
Yeah, you're going to love it.